On October 19, 2017, astronomers observing the Pan-STARRS telescope in Hawaii noticed an object traveling through the stars at remarkable speed. At first, the scientists categorized this object as a comet, then reclassified it as an asteroid before realizing that this was actually something that they had never seen before. Dubbed Oumuamua, Hawaiian for scout, this was actually the first interstellar object observed in our solar system. But that was only the start of what made Oumuamua extraordinary.
It was kind of like the most remarkable discovery in astronomy at that point in time, because although we had been expecting there to be interstellar objects in the galaxy, we had never seen a small body in the solar system that was definitively from another solar system. So at the time, it was such an amazing opportunity that I immediately dropped everything I was working on to work on Oumuamua.
But to understand what makes Oumuamua so unique, it might be helpful to get a basic astronomy refresher. Asteroids are solid, rocky objects that appear as small pins of light when seen through telescopes and revolve around the sun in elliptical orbits. Comets are composed of ice and dust particles which burn up as they pass near stars in a process known as outgassing. This gives comets their signature tails and comas, and also gives them a boost of acceleration as they speed through the solar system. And while Oumuamua looked like an asteroid, it behaved like a comet, speeding up and changing course as it exited our solar system. So if it wasn't a comet, and it wasn't an asteroid, then what was Oumuamua?
What was great about the object, but also very mysterious, was that in every way we expected these interstellar comets to behave, Oumuamua just acted exactly the opposite. So it was a complete mystery from the very beginning. So we know that solar system comets have non-gravitational accelerations. We've measured that on plenty of solar system comets. But there, what's happening is that the ice on the comet is heating up, sublimating, producing the kind of beautiful outflow and tail, bringing dust along with it that you see, and then that pushes the object away from the sun. But the fact that Oumuamua had no cometary tail yet had a non-gravitational acceleration was very strange. And that's what led to a multitude of hypotheses about the provenance of the object.
The mysterious nature of Oumuamua captured the imaginations of scholars and amateur astronomers alike. But in a paper publishing in the journal Nature this month, Seligman and his colleague, Jennifer Bergner from UC Berkeley, believe that they have finally cracked the mystery of Oumuamua. And while their insights might not be as fanciful as alien spacecrafts, they do believe that Oumuamua could be the first of an entirely new classification of celestial objects, something they're calling dark comets.
And now, since the discovery of Oumuamua in 2017, we have now discovered 6 near-Earth objects or small bodies in the solar system that had those exact same mysterious properties of the dark comets, which are, they're accelerating in addition to the sun's gravitational influence and presumably due to outgassing, but have no coma or dust tail at all. And so it's almost like Oumuamua was so intensely studied because it came from outside of the solar system. It showed us that there's this entire new population of objects in the solar system, these dark comets. And you could make the argument that the comets and the asteroids have told us more about the formation and evolution of the solar system and the solar system's planets than the planets themselves. So part of the reason that this field is so exciting right now, and Oumuamua and the promise of future discoveries and potentially a spacecraft going to an interstellar comet to tell us about the detailed composition of something that formed in an exoplanetary system, is that I think that these population of objects could tell us more about the formation and evolution of exoplanetary systems than the exoplanets that we've recently been discovering. And so by studying interstellar comets, you can really put the Earth and the solar system within its cosmic context.